Good morning, children. We are continuing the chapter locomotion and movement. We have already studied the structure of muscle fibers. I have told you muscle bundle consists of muscle fibers. Muscle fibers contain sarcomere, the functional unit, and the sarcomere in turn contain myofibrils or myofilaments called actin and myosin. And thereafter we have studied what are these myofibrils or myofilaments, or they are actin and myosin filament. And we have studied the actin is the thin filament, protein filament, and the myosin is the thick protein filament. We have studied that much and seen the picture or diagram as well. Today I am repeating that the sarcomere. What is the sarcomere? Sarcomere is the functional unit of the muscle fibers. It is the sarcomere that undergo contraction and relaxation during the action of the muscles. So the contraction and the relaxation of the sarcomere is due to the presence of the muscle myofibrils or myofilaments called actin and myosin. I have told you the red line one is called actin. Actin are thin filament, thin protein filament. Whereas this yellow color ones are called thicker myosin filament. So myosin are thicker and actin are thin, which are arranged in the alternating manner in the sarcomere. A sarcomere represents this in between two set lines. So this is one sarcomere, this is another sarcomere, another cell. So like the sarcomeres are connected one after another, and large number of sarcomeres are connected one after another and form a continuous banded structure. And a sarcomere in turn contains the actin, thin filament, the protein filament actin, and the myosin filament. The arrangement of actin and myosin form different types of bands. I am telling about the resting fiber, the structure of the resting fiber, sarcomere of a resting fiber which is fully relaxed. Okay, that is called resting fiber. And there are sarcomeres. Sarcomere is the functional unit of the muscle fibers. Sarcoplasm means the fluid filled inside the sarcomere. There filled a fluid called a sarcoplasm. Now, sarcolemma is the membrane lining the sarcomere. Membrane lining the sarcomere is called sarcolemma. Inside the sarcoplasm, you can see an arrangement of actin and myosin. Actin and myosin. So, what is the first idea? First one, I band. What is I band? I band represents the actin region, active part, only actin region on either sides of the sarcomere. On either sides of the cell line, or joining to the cell line are but actin filament. They are actin filament alone constitute the I band. Then A band is there. A band represents. You can see A band represents the region in the sarcomere where the myosin and a part of actin overlap. This region is called anisotropic band. I band is called isotropic band because it contains only actin. Anisotropic band constitute both actin, a segment of the actin, and the entire length of the what we say myosin. So total myosin length and a part of the actin together known as the anisotropic band. And here at the center you can see the myosin only, that from the H line. Okay. So that's all about this introduction. You must know about what is I band, what is H, what is okay, and what is anisotropic band, what is isotropic band. All this is the structure of the resting resting fiber. The structure of a resting fiber. That's all. Thank you.